Welcome back. My name is Patricia Regier with Regier Education Incorporated. So I'm sharing today a tutorial on recording your audio here through Zoom. So that's why I'm not on camera, because I want to demonstrate that you can use Zoom to record a recording of a course, background information, if you're adding it to a video, if you're going through a slide deck and building your self-directed learning course. So there's a variety of reasons why you might want to create an audio file. And Zoom is one of the places that you can do that if this is the easiest access to a program that you have. Now, a very good mic, a good soundproofish room all helps, because people are experiencing the audio, and if there are issues with the audio, that can detract from paying attention to the content. So that's something to keep in mind. A great mic, or you know, what you have accessible to you, is important. And then here in Zoom, what I did was just hit the recording button and started talking. So it will create an audio file, and I will take you through then where you will find that file, and then what kind of file you can send. Sometimes too, I'm using other programs to take the audio files and upload them to a podcast. So this might be another reason why you're using Zoom to create that audio file. Some important things to keep in mind is that you want your pace to be the way you'd be presenting the information. So if you're going through a slide deck, perhaps on a second screen, or you hit record and maybe you're sharing that screen. So even if you're off camera, but you're going through the pace, going through your content as if someone is also watching that information, even if you're taking that file and then adding it to something else that you're creating. So definitely keep in mind pace, that you don't rush through the narrative, and that you're also adding that enthusiasm, the excitement that you would have if you are speaking to someone or if they're even seeing you. So, you know, you may have heard this before, smiling and just upping that excitement, because the inflection and enthusiasm in your voice is going to carry through in that audio file. So these are some tips, and just basically recording, and I'm going to demonstrate that here as well. So next, I am ending the meeting, and then the file will be processed. So I hit end on the bottom right, and meeting for all. And then you'll see that this converting meeting recording begins. And then I'll take you through where you will find that. Doesn't take very long if your recording isn't too long, but if you're talking for an hour, that file will be larger. At that point, you may want to have that file, especially if it's just an audio file, going to the cloud, and I'll take you through how to share that. But when I'm recording on my computer, then when it's finished, this box will open up right away, so I don't have to go looking for it. And it's the audio files. If I've stopped in the middle of something, then I will have multiple files, and then you want to send those multiple files as well. You will often find it in your documents, and there is a Zoom folder, and then with today's date, it will automatically do that. I will take you through how you can retrieve that information if you are having the recording going to the cloud. I often record on my computer, because then I can grab that file from there. And I also find that video files are a little bit better quality as well. When I can pause the recording at any point,
recording
or
in progress,
I can stop the recording. And then when I hit stop, I'll take you through the next steps as well.
Recording stopped.
For Zoom, perhaps you have the Zoom app on your computer and you open this up. You want to click Start New Meeting, and then you can open that up. Make sure that your mic is recording. Testing, testing. And then you hit record. And then record to the cloud.
Recording in progress.
Now you would unmute yourself, but I'm recording this audio on another platform. Continue without audio, meeting audio not fully recorded. It will let you know that, which is good. Up at the top, there is also where you see pause or stop on the bottom navigation bar and at the top as well. And this little green shield, there's a gear that you can open up for your settings. You can go to audio. And then this is where you can also double check. It's another place in addition to right beside the mic icon at the bottom. You can also open up the settings to make sure too that the background sounds are suppressed. So you can adjust the settings here just as another place where you can make adjustments if needed. And you'll see in the top right that the recording will be converted once the meeting ends. So again, I'm going to end meeting for all. But I'm going to take you through to your recordings in your account. So when you get to your Zoom account, it's going to be through the browser. That is where you can find on the left menu where you have under personal home. Yours might look a little bit different depending on the type of account that you have, but this is where you can go to the cloud recordings. And it's processing right now. And what actually popped up on my second screen here is ready to view. So I can click view here, even though it's looking like it's changing there. So it opens up another menu here and I can download the file. And then separate audio file for each participant won't be included. That it depends on your settings of what you've arranged. But if it's just you talking, probably don't need to worry about that. And then it's sent a MP4 when you just hit download. What we are looking for with the audio file is the audio only. You can open that up to test it, but you can also right here, when you hover over this audio only, you'll see the download symbol right there. And then you can click that download. And now it's an M4A file. If I need to convert it to MP3, I can do that on my end. So that is the process of what you do for retrieving an audio file from the cloud, if that's your setup, or you can retrieve it from your documents if you've recorded the audio from your onto your home computer. So that is what you need to do for a recording through Zoom.